When we got on some of these first soils, 0.4, 0.5% organic matter. We're 2.3 to 2.8 currently. Yeah. Taking a look at soil health, we monitor. So we've monitored and said, hey, what's the cover crop, soil health, all the tools in the toolbox. What is it doing throughout the year, throughout the production? Number one, pecans, number one thing is moisture, water. What causes nut drop, what causes quality issues, what is all these things? It's all driven by moisture, water, a lot of it's fertility, but so that soil health, as you increase your soil health and you're maintaining moisture. So one of the big products is moisture. So you're going through, you're gonna level off your on and off years, you're gonna maintain your moisture, you're gonna maintain your quality, you're gonna stabilize that quality at a high level. I mean, you can see we did infiltration tests out here.
Okay.
And we're getting super good infiltration. And this is a silty clay loam.
Yeah, yeah.
And we're getting really fast infiltration rates. Our big monsoon storm just came through this weekend, and we got between 1.5 and 1.7 inches. And all of the orchards here in our cover crops, all that water stayed in the orchard. You can see around bar ditches and around the roads, how much water it was, and we didn't have any water leaving these orchards at all. Yeah, regardless of the slope, everything stayed in the orchard. And in conjunction with your hedging and topping program and monitoring your fertility and keeping those microbials, all your beneficials, everything as all the tools in a toolbox is gonna drive your yield and quality. And that's what we monitor. And I think that's the driving force, not to mention your end result is once you have these cover crops and you've got this, your passes through the field, your overall diesel consumption, your fuel consumption, everything, your labor, it's just better for the bottom line. We don't have that cost. We don't have these costs to drive through the field. We don't have tillage operations going on. Once these cover crops are planted, we're in here mowing. That's it.
Yeah. So are you producing the same yields and the same quality as conventional with lower costs, or are you actually seeing higher yields as well?
I don't have side-by-side comparisons, but I know from a cost standpoint, looking at number of fields on number of passes and the costs associated with that in conventional farming, we're way ahead.